Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.com.
Hi students, good afternoon to everyone. This is the third video regarding cockroach type study. In the cockroach type study, previously we started about morphology of a cockroach, external morphology we see. In that external morphology, especially head region, what are the parts are there? That we completed last video, mouth parts. Okay, in this video, continuation of that mouth part diagrammatic explanation, I will be explaining in the end of this video session. Then, first starting of this video, I would like to continue about abdominal region and thoracic region. What are the parts are present in the abdominal of the cockroach and thoracic? Second part thorax and then third part abdomen. Okay, then let me start today video session. See, nana, morphology of a cockroach. You know, cockroach is scientific name Periplaneta americana. Basically, by the external morphology, we can distinct the three parts, that is a head part and thorax and then abdomen. In the previously head part, it is made up of six segments, but that six segments are not a tapirians in the head region. It is embryonic segments only. So by embryonic segment all together to form the head capsule. By head capsule, it will form a triangular structure of the head. That triangular shape of the head hanging in the right angle to the thorax and then abdomen. So that is the reason head we called as a hypognathous head. Okay, that last video. And then these head consisting with are bears, sensory organs and mouth parts. Sensory organs are we already known antennas, correct na? And then compound eye, mouth parts, cutting and chewing. Type of mouth parts we seen in the cockroach. The diagrammatic explanation mouth parts, the end of this video I will explain. Let me start today content, that is a thorax. Thorax of the cockroach made up of or consisting with three segments. That three segment name already last video we discussed. So in short form I explained here, pro, meso, meta. What is a pro means first thorax part we called as a chamber segment we called as a prothorax, later mesothorax and metathorax. These three chambers are three segments of the thorax of cockroach. It contains the two important structures. One important structure is three pairs of legs, especially simply locomotory appendages, locomotory organelles, legs. See, here these locomotory organs, based on that only, these cockroach belongs to arthropoda, jointed legs. Correct only, na? Recall that previous video information. So, how many pairs of walking legs are there? Three pairs of walking legs are there and two pairs of wings. Okay. Now, your doubt, sir, three pairs of walking legs, where they are located and in which place they are present and then two pairs. Easily we can say here how many segments are there in thorax? Thorax, three segments. So each pair of walking legs are arising from the each and appropriate suitable segment, thorax segment. For first pair of walking leg present at the place of the prothorax and second place, second legs meso, and the third pair of walking legs belongs to meta. So it is equally arranged. Okay, how many sets of how many segments are there, that many number of pairs of walking legs are there. Then when you coming to the wings, here how many wings are there? Two pairs of wings. How many segments are there? Three segments. So which segment is empty? Which segment? Okay, pro thoracic segment is there, na? It is empty. That empty mean that prothorax place there is no any wing. So these two pairs of wing is articulated with the thoracic segment at the place of the pro and mesothoracic place one, and then meso metathoracic segments joint place is there, na? That place it is there. Okay, so in between the pro and mesothoracic one places one pair of wing, and meso to metathoracic segments between one more pair of wings are there. What is the significance of these wings? That we should be know. See, nana, here I mentioned two pairs of wings are there. That two pairs of wings names we called as a fore wings and hind wing. Fore wing and hind wing. First pair of wings and second pair of wings. These four wings are also called as a mesothoracic. Why it is a mesothoracic? Second segment would name anna. This is a mesothoracic. So it is located nearby the mesothorax segment, so that's why they kept the name as a meso. Then as usually the second one, metathoracic, hind wing represented metathoracic because of it is located in the last thoracic segment. Okay, and then these prothoracic segment, prothoracic wing, we call the tegmina. Four wings also called as a tegmina, right? What is the these wings function? How it is appears? See, the differentiation between the fore wings and hind wings, a little variation in structural variation we can find, and then functional variation also we can find. Structural variation wise, the color opaque and dark, nothing but a dark shade, brown color, opaque and dark, and very leathery, so much of thickness is there. Okay, and it covers the total body, and second pair of wings when the total organism is a resting condition. Okay, physically and phenotypical variation, it is a dark in color, opaque and dark in color, and their function only covers the hind wings when they are taking rest. Okay, then this is the time to know what is the hind wing work. See here, metathoracic or hind wings, it is a transparent, nothing but when you place the light on the these wing, light will be penetrate. Okay, and membranous, just very thin, not much thick. Okay, so structurally these two, four wings and hind wings are differ. Structurally what it is differ, color variation is there, and then thickness also variation. Here four wings are opaque and dark, it is a transparent, it is a leathery, it is a membrane. Okay, what is the functional variation mean? These and all mesothoracic or four wings function only give the protection, cover the body and four hind wings. But these hind wings are useful for flying time. Okay, cockroach can able to fly, but not high heights. Okay, up to 5 feet, 6 feet onwards only it will be fly. Okay, so the balancing of body up to certain limits for flying purpose, these metathoracic or hind wings are playing important role. So this is the one major question, na? How many pairs of wings you can see in the cockroach? What is the structural and the functional variation in that two pairs of wings? First pair of wing functional structural variation, we can find it. Okay, that is a major thing. Okay, then wings characteristic, wings topic completed. Then already I explained about leg, but details about the leg. Here why we need to know about the details about the leg mean, we already mentioned one statement, according to the legs only these arthropoda name is given, and then these organism belongs to arthropoda phylum. You know significance of the arthropoda statement. Artho means jointed, poda means legs. So here that arthropoda legs in the cockroach we want to know. So here leg of cockroach, basically how many pairs of walking legs are there? 3 pairs of walking legs are there. So either sides 3, 3. So now if you take one walking leg analysis, the leg containing with 5 segments, we consider as a 5 segments is a 5 joints. So 5 segments are attaching with one joint. So 5 segmented, that 5 segments of legs we call as a podomeres. What it is? Podomeres, pointer place parangana. Podo means leg, meres means subunits. So in the leg part subunits we call as a podomeres. 5 segmented leg, that 5 segments we call as a podomeres. First podomere name, this pointer place clearly parangana. First place, this is a coxa. Okay, second part trochanter. Trochanter, third part femur, and fourth part tibia, fifth part tarsus. Already I said na leg containing with how many podomeres? 5 podomeres. First podomere name coxa, second podomere name trochanter, third femur, and fourth tibia and tarsus. I think so you find two similar words already you heard it. Somewhere you heard in the skeletal system of the human being, these two words I used, tibia and femur, correct na? Tarsus also we used, tarsomeres we used. Okay, so especially these femur and tibia, already it is existed in our bone, our skeletal system also. So the same thing, the same type of structures, but primitive structures we find in the leg of cockroach. So should be remember these 5 podomere name. Okay, the sequence order you should be remember. Later in the last podomere name edannanna tarsus kada, tarsus again it consisting with 5 subunits. So 5 subunits name simply we call as a tarsomeres. Why it is tarsomeres? Meres means a subunit, tarsus a subunit, so that's why they kept a name as a tarsomeres. Okay, va? And the end of the last tarsomere, claw is there. If you observe the bird leg, it has a claw. Correct the bird? How? Birds legs are having the claw for holding wise. This organism also, cockroach also having the claw. In between of that claws, okay, a sponge like structure is there. A sponge like structure that is called arolium. That is called arolium. This arolium play an important role in the rough surface movement. Okay, when the cockroach is moving the something rough area, rough wall, the surface area is giving to the friction. So based on the friction, cockroach can able to move the in the lateral, I mean wall itself also. Okay, with the help of the these arolium. And then when the cockroach moving on the tiles, something smooth area, for that one, plantulae, these plantules are arranging on the tarsomeres are there now. On the surface of the tarsomeres, just hair-like, feather-like structures are there. That feather-like structures we call as a plantulae. These plantules are playing an important role in the smooth surface, walking of the smooth surface area. Okay, these are the structures in the leg. One leg of the cockroach made up of the 5 segments. That 5 segments are we called as a podomeres. First segment coxa, second segment name tarsa, trochanter, third one femur, fourth one tibia, sixth one tarsus. That tarsus again having the 5 subunits, that subunit names
or tarsomeres. In the last tarsomere, it contains aroleum, cla. In between the cla, aroleum is there. And each and every tarsomere, feathery structures are there that we call the plantulae. These plantulae and aroleum play a significant role in the movement of the organism in the smooth and rough surface areas.
Okay. And here I didn't mention what
how the cockroach is moving. Cockroach moving by the tripod system. Tripod. Basically, how many pods are there? Pod means legs. Okay, six legs are three pairs. One side three and the another side three. Totally six. When you take pair system, three pairs. So when the walking of any surface area, tripod system mechanism will applicable. That means one side two legs, another side one leg. In the three legs, which leg is moving? So one side first and last leg, another side middle leg. So by movement wise, if it is using the three legs, automatically it is called a tripod system. Okay. Neat explanation time, I will be give some more something more. Okay, then come to the second column, that abdomen. Up to now we discussed about thorax. Thorax may having the wings and legs. Wings wise we discussed and legs also completed. Then come to the abdominal places. In the abdominal places, it consisting with 10 segments. Already in the diagrammatic representation also, you got the clarity. Okay, so totally abdomen 10 segments. Now can you calculate how many segments are present in the cockroach? By visually 14 segments. How 14 segment? Head totally, if you take one segment, it is a capsule, then three segments in thorax, and then 10 segments in abdominal region. 10 plus 3 plus 1. But in the really, if you want to count, means head containing with how many segments made up of the 6 embryonic segments. So 6 embryonic segments and then 3 thoracic segments and 10 abdominal segments. These number of segment numbers you should be remember, Nanna. So 10 plus 3, 13, 13 plus 6, 19. Totally cockroach body approximately 19 segments are there. So each and every segment of the abdomen, it's covered by the one plate. That plates we call as a sclerites. I think so in the last class also we discussed about the sclerites. On that time I given the one example, roof one side and then floor one more side, but adjacent side and lateral sides walls are there. Like each and every plate of cockroach body, that we call as a sclerite. But the name of the sclerite is differ from the basing on their position. If sclerite is a dorsal position, that is a tergum. If the sclerite is a ventral position, that is a sternum. Time to recall, in the time of skeletal system explanation time, sternum, one word you heard it. That sternum word, nothing but in rib case, in the our ventral side, one straight, stiff bone we call it the sternum. In which side it is there? Ventral side only, na? So dorsal and ventral. Dorsal side tergum and ventral side. So in the lateral side we have the rib case in the skeletal system. Instead of the rib case we are calling here pleura. So lateral sclerites we call the pleura and dorsal sclerite we call the tergum and ventral sclerite we call as a sternum. These names you should be remember. Then come to the point. Okay, see dorsal side which plates are there? Tergal plates. And then ventral side what plates are there? Sternas. Okay, in abdomen how many segments are there? 10 segments. Okay, so based on that what we can say, 10 segments are there in the abdomen of the cockroach, so 10 tergas are there. Okay, simultaneously we can say 10 sternums also is present, but here 10 tergas are there, that means dorsal plates 9 sternums only is present. Why sir, 9 sternums only present? 9th one is a bigger size, so when it is making differentiated into the adult one, 9th and 10th sternums are fusing to each other to form the big sternum. So 9 sternums only visible, but 10 tergas are present in the dorsal side. Okay, that you should be remember. And then by seeing of cockroach's body, we can able to distinguish male cockroach and female cockroach. Male cockroach and female cockroach. That differentiation of the male and female cockroaches like this. See, this side I am mentioning about male cockroach and then this side female cockroach. Here, 8th tergum is not visible. 8th tergum. Why 8th tergum is not visible? I will tell reason. Here, female, in female cockroach, 8th and 9th tergum. What is the tergum? Tergum means dorsal sclerite, we call the tergum. Correct only now. Here in male cockroach, only 8th tergum only not visible. In the female, 8th and 9th tergums are not visible. Reason nanna in the boxular explainability. 7th one is a very big one. That 7th chela, under by the 7th sternum, these 8th tergum in the male and females, 8th and 9th tergums are existed. Okay, arranged. So, due to the overlapped by the 7th tergum, under the 7th tergum in the male 8th tergum is present and then in the female 8th and 9th tergums also present. That is the one reason. Based on the tergum appearance, how many tergums are visible, we can able to distinguish the male and the female cockroaches. Then later come to the point, we said now the dorsal sclerite. Now this is the time to tell about ventral sclerite. Ventral sclerite we call it as sternum. In the male, basically how many sternums are there? 9 sternums. That in the, especially in the male, the 9th sterna is visible. 9th sternas are visible, no doubt. But in female, 7th sternas are only visible. That means 9th and then 8th, 7th, 8th, 9th sternas are fusion to each other. Okay, in the male we discussed about tergum, tergum. Now we are discussing about sternum, sterna. So here, as usually, 9 sternas are visible. And then here only 7 sternas are visible because of 9th, 8th and 9th are fusion with 7th sterna or maybe under the 7th sterna. So that is the reason. And then one more differentiation of the male and female cockroaches, a pair of anal cirri and anal styles gonophophysis. These are the reproductive structures. A pair of anal cirri, anal style, gonophophysis are present in the male cockroach. But a pair of anal cirri and gonophophysis we can see in the females also, but here in females anal styles are absent. Okay, so what is the difference between the male and female cockroaches? Male cockroaches having the anal cirri, anal style and gonophophysis. Here in female cockroach, anal cirri and then gonophophysis are present, but anal style is absent. That is a major difference. And then come to the one more difference, genital aperture, genital aperture hole. That genital aperture presence in the below the anus. But here in male, in female, genital aperture present in the eighth sternum. Eighth sternum means ventral side kadana. So that is eighth sternum having a small hole, that is a genital aperture. That is the differentiation of the male cockroach and female cockroaches. Some more details are there, but it need in the neat level, not board level, sir. And then in the last column, I explained about mouth parts of a cockroach. Okay, already I explained in the theoretical explanation, that is a biting and the cutting and then chewing type of mouth parts. What parts we seen in that time? Five important parts I explained. That are diagrammatic representation, labrum and labium. Labrum upper lip, labium lower lip. Okay. Then mandibles, crushing missions. Okay, crushing organs, mandibles. And then holding of the food items wise, it has the maxillae. Okay, simply I said first maxillae. How many pairs of maxillae are there? Two pairs of maxillae are there. This one. This is the first pair and this is the second pair. Two pairs of maxillae. And then in the middle of the mouth parts, a tongue-like structure is there, that is a hypopharynx. Hypopharynx. So this is the diagrammatic representation of cockroach mouth parts. Idhukku munnadi we discussed about the abdominal structures of the cockroach, how we can able to distinguish the male cockroach with the female cockroach in the abdominal portions. Especially this is the major differentiation. Anal cirrhae, anal style and gonophophysis are present in the male cockroach and anal styles are absent. That means anal cirrhae is present and gonophophysis are present in the female cockroach. And a genital aperture presence in the anal pore. That means in the 10th segment. Okay, here a genital aperture is present in the 7th, 8th sternum. Okay, adhikamunnadi we discussed about thoracic segment structures. Okay, the later in the next class, I would like to start about physiology of cockroach.